Hello class 7th, how are you? This is Yogita Naidu from Holy Arts Educational Academy, Raipur. Students, today we are going to take the fourth lesson of our supplementary book, that is The Cop and the Anthem. The cop means the police and the anthem means a national song or a song. But in this lesson, the character repeats the same thing again and again. That's why it has become the name of the lesson as The Cop and the Anthem. Before we start this lesson, children, I want to ask you two questions. Do ever anyone wants to do a crime, wants to become a criminal, or wants to go to a jail? Yes, the answer will be no and never. And the second question is, if something happens what we thought and something happens reverse of that, so what will be our feelings? Of course, it will be very bad. We feel very bad that what we thought and has become different, or something different has happened. So in this lesson, we are going to talk about these two situations. Now let's start the lesson. Soapy is a character, a hero of the lesson. He was sitting idle on the bench of a park in the Broadway street in New York. He was sitting idle because he was jobless and homeless. Sitting there, he was just wondering that how he is going to deal with the winters that are going to approach in New York. As in New York, the winters are too chilly, it's too difficult to survive in that weather. So he was homeless and plus jobless, so he was just worried about how to pass 3 months of wintry days and nights. So he thought, the things are coming to his mind that how to deal with this. So looking around him, he found that the birds are also started migrating towards the south to protect themselves from this wintry days, and the people started purchasing new coats, new jackets to protect themselves from the wintry days. So thinking like that, he just moved from the park and just started to move on the pavilion of the street. So looking here and there, an idea came to his mind. He was thinking that I don't want any sort of pleasure days. He don't want to go to any voyage, or he don't want to go across the Mediterranean Sea to enjoy these winter days, but he just wants to be in the prison of Blackwell's Island. Is it surprising, no? Anyone wants to go to a prison, to a jail, and that is in the Blackwell's Island. He wanted to be safe because he will get food, bed, shelter there without any questions from the cops. That was his desire. So because he can get any of the job, but for that he has to just answer the questions that the people will ask, who he is, from where he has come, about his parents. So he don't like to answer all these questions to anyone, so he just desires to be in the jail, to be in the prison, that no cop will follow him, no cop will ask him anything, only he will just enjoy the bed, shelter and food over there for 3 months. So this is his desire. So for this, he have to do some wrong things, or he have to do take chance of some of the attempts to be in the prison. So he started to think what he has to do. He was thinking that it is a very easy task that easily I can do, and then I will be sentenced to be in the prison. So he just looked around himself and he found that there was a good restaurant, a rich restaurant where the rich people, rich food is provided over there. So he thought to go into that restaurant, and easily he will get entry into that because he was well from the top. That is, his coat is well, his face is clean, and his coat is also clean. So he will easily get entry into the restaurant, and then he will order a good dinner from that place, and then he will say that I don't have money. thinking like that, he just tried to just enter into the restaurant, but suddenly the hand came from its back, and when he turned, he saw the head waiter who just stopped him and looked at his torn shoes and torn clothes. Looking at his shoes, the head waiter just kicked him out. So the first attempt of Sophie was failed. He thought that it was very easy, that I will order something and I will just cop will come and catch him. But his first attempt failed. Secondly, he got little disappointed, and then he tried for the next attempt. Looking moved, he just started to move ahead, and he found a shop over there where there were beautiful lights, and there was a huge window with beautiful lights shining in that shop. So he took a stone and just threw a stone through the window, and he didn't run. He was just standing over there. Looking at this, a cop came towards him and asked Sophie, who did it? Sophie asked, it is me only who has thrown the stone. Don't I do this? The cop said that a person who will just throw a stone never stand at the same place. He must have ran away from this place. So listening this, Sophie got disappointed, and the police just saw another man running on the road. The cop followed that man. So in this way, the second attempt also failed of Sophie. So he was just getting that whether I will ever be caught by the cop, and will I enjoy my winters in the jail. This was the two attempts. Then the third attempt he took, that he saw another restaurant that was not as good as the restaurant of the Broadway, where not rich people used to come, only the simple people used to come over there, and not a good food is provided there. So he thought that now I will go into this restaurant. So he just entered, and no one stopped him to enter in this restaurant, and he got a seat over there. He settled. He had a good dinner, and then when the waiter asked him to pay the money, the Sophie said, no, I don't have money. And then Sophie said to him, please call the cop and don't make a gentleman wait for the cop. It's not a good thing. So the head waiter came, and he just answered, there is no need to call a cop. Just we will call her waiters. And the waiters came and just holded ears and just threw him out of the restaurant. Then Sophie stood and he just cleaned his coat, and he started to move. He was just thinking, moving ahead, that it's like a star to be in the it's like a star in the sky, that I will never catch him or I will never be in the jail. Then he started to move to the another side of the Broadway, where he found some theaters. There were several theaters in that place, and where the rich people used to go, and they are enjoying the beautiful winter nights over there. And he thought, yes, where here the people are so happy, the women are so happy, the people are wearing rich clothes, and there were so many theaters over there. A cop was standing near one theater. So Sophie went close to that theater, and he started to shout as loud as he can. He was shouting as he is a drunkard, and he shouted, he was dancing over there, he was crying over there, and he started to shout. The cop looked at him, and then he said to the another man standing near the cop, that these college boys, that is, he thought that Sophie is a college kind of boy, so he said that these college boys are allowed to shout, and we are ordered not to catch them. That means these college students are not supposed to be caught by the police. So the police just moved away from that place, and Sophie was again disappointed. he started to move, then he thought of to take the another attempt, and he looked at one of the shop where a man was buying a newspaper. A umbrella was kept beside that man, so Sophie went into that shop and just took the umbrella, and he started to move fast. Sophie just took that umbrella and started to move ahead. Looking this, the man also started to follow him and said, "Sir, it is mine." So Sophie said to that man, "Why don't you call a cop who is standing at the corner of the street?" Hearing this, the man got confused. He started to move towards the police. Sophie also followed him. And when they came close to the police, the man said, "Sir, today this I got in one of the restaurant. It's not mine. If it is yours, so you can keep it with you." Sophie said, "Yes, it is mine only," and the man ran as fast as he can, and the police also went away. Again, Sophie was very much disappointed. He thought that he was losing hope whether any police will ever catch me. So he was so disappointed that he threw the umbrella as far as he can, and he became very much frustrated about these attempts. Finally, then what he did, he started to move towards the Broadway street. He was just very much disappointed, and he started to move towards the Broadway street, and suddenly he stopped at one of the house. The house was so beautiful. There were full of lights, and that was Sophie's childhood house, where he has enjoyed so many pleasant days with his mother, with his friends, with his relatives. Standing there, he just hear a sweet music was coming from the living room of his house. That sound just made him to feel something else. He was just recalling all the peaceful days, all the enjoyable days that he has spent with his family. So listening to that music, there was a tremendous change in his soul. Now he wanted to do something else. He was just thinking that how much fool he was, how much wrong he was, just that he has wasted his life, he has wasted his time doing all the wrong things. He always thought of wrong desires, dead hopes, and worthless days. Now he want to completely change his lifestyle, and he want to get some job. He wanted to know, from tomorrow onwards I have to change myself. I want to get my old golden days back, where I was happy with my family. So he was just thinking that tomorrow in the morning I should get a job. First, I will find the man who has once offered me a job, and I can easily find him somewhere in the New York, and then I will do some job, and then I will change my life. He was just feeling bad of himself that how much worthless days he had spent on the wrong desires he had. Just he was standing and thinking, suddenly he felt a hand on his back, and when Sophie turned, he saw the broad face of a cop. The cop asked, "What are you doing here, mister?" So Sophie said, "No, nothing. I was just standing here." Then the cop said, "Do you think that I am a fool that you are standing here? Come on, come with me." Sophie started to argue with the police, but the police didn't listen to him. Then the cop said to him that you are not supposed to argue with the New York cops, it's against the law. Come on. Then he took with him, and the next day the judge just sentenced him with 3 months imprisonment in the Backwells Island. So this is about what the character Sophie, when he wanted to change his life, he want to become a good person, then suddenly the things has happened against what he thought. This is about the lesson, the cop and the anthem. Hope you have understood the lesson, children. And so many attempts he has taken to be in the prison, to be in the jail. But finally, when he wanted to change, he was just caught by the police. Children, apart from studying, the school has also introduced some competitions for you people. So participate in a good number for the school and get very, very good results in that also. Okay, take very good care of yourself. Bye.